let us solve our fourth question, which is R is equal to under root of 2a divided by 3h, right? And we have to change the subject of the formula to h. That means we have to keep h to one side and all the variables to other side of equality sign. Now let us see how to do this. R is equal to under root of 2a by 3h, right? Now you know that we have under root, that means we should square the both side. So that means squaring both sides, we get R square is equal to, the under root gets cancelled out and we have 2a divided by 3h, right? Now we have to keep h on one side, right? So that means let us take 3h on the other side. We have R square into 3h equals to 2a, right? Now take this R square to other side of equality sign. Now this is in multiplication, so when it is taken to the other side, it comes in denominator, right? We have R square. Now we have 3h is equal to 2a by 3 R square, and we also need to take this 3 to other side of equality sign. So it becomes h is equal to 2a divided by R square. This again 3 will go in the denominator. We can write this as equal to 2a by 3r square. So this is our final formula in which h is our subject, that h is equal to 2a divided by 3r square, right? Now let us see our fifth question, which is e is equal to half m into v square plus m into g into h or mgh. Make m as subject of the formula, which again means keep m to one side and all the variables to other side, and find the value of m when v is equal to 10, g is equal to 10 and h is equal to 5, right? Now let us try to first change the subject of the formula. E is equal to half m v square, that means half into m into v square plus mgh, which is m into g into h. All these three are different variables, right? Now let us take m common because it is present in both the terms. So we have e m. Now when m is taken out from this particular term, I have v square divided by 2, because when m is taken out common, I have half into v square, which is v square by 2, plus when m is taken out common from this term, I have only g into h, right? Now can I take this full bracket to other side of equality sign, and this will help me to easily make this m as subject, right? When this is taken to the other side of equality sign, it becomes as e divided by this whole term, right? V square by 2 plus gh. Because this whole term is in multiplication with m, when taken to the other side of equality, it becomes the denominator. So this is, now this means this is my desired formula in which m is the subject and all other variables are on the other side of equality sign. Now we have to do the second part, in which v is equal to 10, g is equal to 10 and h is equal to 5, right? Let us put in this particular equation. Here e is missing, so let us assume e as equal to 1000, right? Maybe I forgot to write this. E is equal to 1000 and e is equal to 1000. Now we have to find out m, therefore m is equal to e, which is equal to 1000, divided by v square divided by 2. V square, here v is equal to 10, that means v square is equal to 100. So let us write it as 100 divided by 2 plus g into h. Here g is 10 and h is 5. G into h means 10 into 5, which is 50, right? Now you know 100 divided by 2 is actually equal to 50. 50 plus 50 is 100. So I have m is equal to 1000 divided by 100. I can cancel these both zeros, that means m is equal to 10, right? So the answer of first part is this, which is E divided by V square by 2 plus GH, and answer of second part is M is equal to 10. Now let us see our sixth question, which is T is equal to, this is T, T is equal to 2 pi under root of L divided by G plus K, and we have to make G as the subject of our formula. Also we have to find out G when L is equal to 539, this is 539, and T is equal to 44 and K is equal to 1.2. First let us make G as the subject of our formula. T is equal to 2 pi under root of L divided by G plus K, right? Again we have under root, that means we need to square both sides. Squaring both sides, that means here it becomes T square, here it becomes 2 pi under root of L divided by G plus K whole square, right? Now how do we solve this particular term? Now let us solve this term. When this whole bracket is square, this means that we are actually multiplying the term within the bracket with itself, right? It has to be multiplied with 2 pi under root of L divided by G plus K, right? Can I write this square as this? We can write this. Now 2 pi multiplied by 2 pi, it is 4 pi square. Now when this term is multiplied with this term, that means I am squaring the under root of L divided by G plus K, right? That means when we multiply these two terms which have under root, the under root gets cancelled out, and we can write this as L divided by G plus K, right? So this term when squared, it becomes 4 pi square or square of 2 pi and into L divided by G plus K or square of under root of L divided by G plus K. That means it becomes T square equals to 4 pi square into L divided by G plus K. And we have to make G as the subject of our formula, right? Now take 4 pi square to other side of the equality sign. It becomes T square divided by 4 pi square equals to L divided by G plus K, right? Now let us take L to the other side of equality sign. L comes in denominator, because in this side L is present in numerator. So when taken to other side, it becomes T square divided by 4 pi square L, sorry, it is small l equals to 1 divided by G plus K, right? Now let us take the reciprocal of both sides. Taking the reciprocal of both sides means the denominator becomes numerator and numerator becomes denominator in both sides. Reciprocating, right? When reciprocated, 4 pi square L comes in denominator divided by T square comes in denominator equal to G plus K becomes numerator and 1 becomes denominator, or we can simply write it as this. Why have I done this particular step? It is because to take G plus K in numerator, now I can easily shift K to the other side and make G as my subject. So this becomes 4 pi square L divided by T square minus K equals to G, right? This is my first part, which is making G as the subject of the formula. Now let us do our second part, which is find G when L is equal to 539, T equals to 44 and K is equal to 1.2. That means you have to put all these values in this particular formula. So let us write G on one side and write these values in the formula. Now 4 pi square. Now let me tell you, the value of pi is equal to 22/7, right? The value of pi is equal to 22/7. So pi square is 22/7 into 22/7. 22 by 7 into 22 by 7. Right? L can be written as, let me rewrite it so that I have more space. G is equal to 4 into pi square. Pi square is 22 by 7 into 22 by 7. Right? 4 pi square. L is 539. L is 539 divided by T square. Here T is equal to 44. So 44 square means 44 into 44. Minus K. K is 1.2. Now when you will solve whole of this particular equation, you will get G is equal to 9.8. And this is my second part, which is G is equal to 9.8. And this is my first part, in which G is the subject of my formula.